Good afternoon. Are you seeing all that greenery piche piche? Where are we? We are at Manthan, Banjara's Manthan, which is in the city but not in the city. So what does that mean? It's a little away on Airport Road, Bangalore, but it's very close to the city. There is so much of greenery. The place is so quiet. And you must be wondering, ye log udhar kar kya rahe hai? So what are we doing here? We are having a two-day residential camp. The topic is, it starts on Friday in the evening, goes on till the whole of Saturday and till Sunday afternoon. So the topic is being happier with yourself. So people say, main to khushi hoon, I am happy. So the topic is being happier with yourself. Steering this whole two-day workshop is Ali, and we are all over here having a good time. More than around nearly 30 participants are here, and we are trying all different ways and means and checking what am I doing to be happier myself. And starting the topic of today's FB Live, happy memories, over to Ali. So I'm going to quietly get up and Ali is going to quietly come and sit up. Thank you.
Yeah, very, very high and happy day, happy afternoon. For those who are going to watch this later, happy evening, happy night, whatever. But it's a pleasure. You know that every Saturday 2 to 3, we get together, we discuss, we have a lot of interesting questions and I get a lot of interesting comments, which helps me. And today is a little more privileged because we are in this, you know, environment which is green, peaceful, happy, whatever you want to call it. And that is why the topic is the happy memories and what you are going to be doing with them, what you will do with them, right? I read a very nice quote recently which said, cherish memories because memories are the only things that don't change when everyone else does. If you have friends, you have relatives, you have people whom you love, there's no guarantee that they'll continue to be nice to you, no? There's no guarantee that your relationship with them is going to be very good and very harmonious and very, you know, joyful. No guarantee. It will change. But the beauty of it is memories do not change. So memories become your permanent asset. Now let me at this juncture also tell you that once in a while I do come across a counselee who says, my life has been really bad. Right from my childhood I have suffered. I have never had anything good happening to me. Inevitably, you know, there have been challenges, there have been letdowns, there have been hurdles, setbacks. I never got an opportunity to be happy. And that is something which I really feel miserable about as my life goes on. I tell them, yes, you may not have had, in an extreme case, you may not have had any, you know, good experiences, any good incidents in your life which you can cherish. But at the same time, let me tell you, what makes happy memories is something which you just cannot be determined by what others do to you. There may have been people who are bad to you. There may have been people who have really made you suffer or made you, you know, unhappy or whatever it is. But finally, it is you who choose, no? And every memory, or most memories at least, let me say, not every memory, most memories have a happy, you know, component to it. Do you pick that up and use it or do you stick to the unhappy ones? One of the classic examples of that was a person whom I had met, who was doing very well in life, young man with a lot of promise and a lot of good things happening in his life. And he had an accident. That accident cut off his spinal cord and he became a quadriplegic. A quadriplegic is a person who loses control over all four limbs, not just his legs. You see many paraplegics who are on wheelchairs, but their hands are functional. They push their wheelchair, they eat by themselves, they do so many things. A quadriplegic is a person who has lost control over all four limbs. So except above his neck, nothing else is functional. And they have to go through a very long, elaborate rehabilitation process. He was there in the rehabilitation center. And there he met a nurse. This nurse was a person who had had bad experiences with men. Somehow or the other, she was so kind, so soft, that she would only meet men who used to try to take advantage of her, and she used to feel very miserable. So at one point, what happened was that she gave up the idea of marriage. By the way, if you people are hearing some sounds of laughter and giggling and all that, that shows you how people who are attending this Manthan camp are creating more happy memories for them. So I'm not going to stop them from laughing and giggling. Let them do that. It acts as a good backdrop. You know how they do in the videos that somebody cracks a joke and a lot of people laugh and all that. So let this background laughter go on. They are also creating some good memories for themselves and for me also, right? So I come back to this particular person. This nurse was taking care of him. And they connected beautifully. They somehow became very good friends. And they fell in love. Now, she was helping him to gain whatever control over himself that he could. So he couldn't move his hand much. What she had devised was a Velcro stuck to his palm like this with a pen. And with the little movement that he had in his hand, she taught him how to write. And the first note that he wrote, very scribbled, barely legible handwriting, but he wrote, "I had a bad accident. I cursed God. Then I met you. Today I thank God for the accident, because without the accident, I would have never known you." Can you think of that? A person who at the prime of his life, gets completely paralyzed. And yet when he starts writing for the first time, the only thing he writes is that, "I am now thankful to God for that accident." Now, what worse memory can you have of having an accident which paralyzes you? But he found what we call as that silver lining even in that, because he found the love of his life over because of that accident. Obviously, without that, she wouldn't have come into his life. They wouldn't have fallen in love. They wouldn't have married. They married. Now, here again, what used to happen was, everybody used to say, "Oh, she's making such a big sacrifice. Oh, she's married a man who is paralyzed. Poor thing," they used to say. And both of them, the funny thing is, both of them used to laugh at it, because they knew what their relationship was. A good relationship does not depend on the physical condition of the person. The type of relationship, and I saw them from close quarters, that's why I'm sharing this with you. It was amazing. Okay. Few years later, he developed some medical complications and he passed away. I vaguely kept in touch with the wife. Once in a while, I used to be in contact with her. Once I happened to visit her on something, and she pulled out a little album in which on the top she had pasted this note that he had written. He had, of course, subsequently written a lot, and his handwriting also had improved, etc. But right on top, she had posted, she had written this. And the first question that struck me was that, "You, who had decided not to marry, not to have any man in your life, and you are going ahead with your life, you change your decision. You took such a courageous decision to marry this person. You faced so many things from society. You were ridiculing, you were saying, what is this, how can this be a marriage, what is happening, all that you faced. And cruelly, fate struck a blow and he went away. She said, yes, the same way as he said, I also believe that if I had never had him in my life would have been poorer. It was a short relationship, doesn't matter. But I still cherish that. If I could turn the clock back and relive my life, I wouldn't have chosen anything different. I would have still gone ahead with whatever. If I had even known that, yes, he is going to, you know, not last very long. So why am I telling you this very touching story is to help you to understand that whether we want to make memories happy or sad depends on us. And that is where I keep telling people that, you know, it is impossible that you could not have had happy memories. Because you can choose which memory is happy and which memory is not. Now, what I would like all of us to do, if you are not doing it, is please make some sort of a diary or a journal of your happy memories. You know the details, so you don't have to write like a essay on the whole thing. Even if you write one line, my holiday in the year 2003, May, for 5 days at such and such place. You know what it was, what happened in those 5 days, whom you were with, what is it that you enjoyed over there. But just writing that one line brings back into your conscious state. In your subconscious state, you are aware. You remember everything that happened in that vacation. But to bring it to your conscious level, you need that little prop. So that prop can be your journal. I remember unexpectedly meeting so-and-so and I was so thrilled when I met this person. That's it. This, the details, what actually happened, what made you happy remains with you. You don't have to share it with anybody. But if you can, please start making such a journal. And when you make it a habit and you start making this journal, you know what happens? It's amazing. Try it out and see. You start recalling more and more of happy memories. You have to experience it to see. You don't necessarily have to take my word for it. But the more you start focusing on the positive, even partly positive. I remember that I lost my grandmother and she was so dear to me. I loved her so much. She passed away. Now, obviously, that was a sad memory, seeing her pass off. But if you carefully recall, you may recollect that on that particular day, even though I had some other work, I had to be somewhere else, by instinct or for some reason, I decided that, no, I'm going to be with my granny on that day. And you were there. And you shared a few beautiful moments alone with her. And she said a few things which touched your heart. You said a few things which brought a glitter into her eye, a smile on her face. And while you were there with her, she passed away. So aren't you fortunate? If you look at the positive side of it, you could have gone off for your work and then you would have come to know that she's passed away. But you were there. And that is the happy part of a very, very sad incident. So if you can, in your journal, as I said, no, write down that my moments with granny on her last day. And you will automatically have so many things that you can, you know, think of. Once you start building that journal, start reviewing, start reading, start visualizing. In fact, this morning in Manthan, we did a very simple creative visualization process of going back into the past and onto some very, very happy memory and reliving it. You can do it by yourself. If you want to do it through creative visualization, I can give you some tips and how to go about it and all that. But actually, it's not even necessary. You can do it entirely by yourself. You can decide that I want to do this, 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 and you can go ahead and do it. But it is up to you to hold those memories dear to you, to celebrate, to share with others if you feel like. Otherwise, keep it to yourself, but cherish them. Your whole attitude towards life itself changes if you have that type of, you know, exercises or that type of, behavior. Now, what about somebody, as I was telling you, who says that I do not have any happy memories? What I help, if the person is open to it and the person comes to me, counseling, is I tell the person that, okay, you have or you don't have these memories. Let us recall all memories. You have only side memories. No, okay. Start telling me each one of your side memories. And the person starts off. When I was very young, there was a death in the family. Then this happened with the school teacher, or I failed in the exam, or I was bullied by my seniors, or this or that, and the person goes on and on and on. If I make the person talk a little more in detail, okay, you said that when you were in school, you know, you were being bullied. Tell me a little more elaborately about that incident of bullying. And the person starts off. And at some point, the person says, I had this one person who was 1 year senior to me. And you know, he was the only one who stood up for me. All the others were so horrible. They were ganging up to bully me, to tease me, to rag me. Except this one person. Fine. Stop. Can you tell me more and more about this one person and what he did for you? Yeah, you know, he was a person who did that, and when he came to know that these people were bullying me, he came and took me aside, and then he spoke to me. He even took me out and gave me a little treat, or he came and visited me on that Sunday, something like that. Now I say, isn't that a happy memory? Yeah, but all the others, no? The way they behaved with me, the way they were miserable, they are. I'm not denying it. I'm not trying to minimize the bad experience that you went through. It was there. It was real. But just because there was a bad experience, do you want to completely negate the good experience? And what was the good experience? The good experience was that there was this person who was senior to you, who had no reason to stand by you. In fact, he took a risk by standing by you because they could have, you know, ridiculed him, or they could have teased him, or whatever it is. He took that chance of going against the tide, against all these bullies, and he stood by you in whatever may. Now, isn't that a good memory? Yeah. That way, if you see, that part was good. Can you add it to your journal? I have a happy memory of whatever his name was, the way he stood by me. It may be a one-day incident. But remember, it has a long-term impact. And that's why I started off by telling you, cherish memories, because memories are the only things that don't change. In fact, Sonal just reminded me, I was telling you about the creative visualization that we did this morning. Sonal has actually put it on YouTube. I didn't even know that. She is so quick.
Not only FB talk you had on creative
visualization. On creative visualization. Okay. So that is there on YouTube. So if you want to learn creative visualization, just get some practical tips or inputs into it. You can go to YouTube and pick up that thing. A few simple techniques of that. And then you can do it by yourself. You can modify it and you can do it in whichever way. But let me tell you that that is a very, very good tool or technique, creative visualization, if you want to use it to recall and to give a boost to your happy memories. Okay. At the same time, as we were discussing, there have been bad memories. There have been this gang of your schoolmates who continuously teased you, or bullied you or whatever it is. Now, what you need to do is to resolve it within your own self. You don't have to meet them. You don't have to have anything to do with them. They are gone somewhere. We don't know who they are, where they are. But your memories are still with you. So can you resolve those painful memories? How do you do that? Tell yourself that these people, maybe they suffer from some sort of insecurity or low self-esteem, and by throwing their weight around a junior and trying to bully him, they are desperately trying to reinforce their own self. How sad their life must be, no? That they weren't happy within themselves. They were a gang of friends. They could make friends. They could play games. They could do whatever it is. But the very fact that they chose not once, twice, but number of times to catch hold of a junior and to tease him or bully him. Aren't they people who should be pitied rather than be angry with? Now you change your attitude and that same trauma doesn't appear as painful as it was up till now. And the more you start reducing the impact of the past bad memories, the more the good memories start, you know, coming up. And let me tell you, it enriches your current life, your daily life. If the more and more you cherish your past happy memories, you get enriched and you get strengthened to face anything which is there. So like I was giving you this example, you were bullied in school or you were put down by a parent or so whatever happened to you, or when you started working when you were a junior, you know, some people took advantage and your boss was horrible, or you had a bad relationship which finally broke up and which, you know, didn't turn out to be all that good. All these things, if you learn to look at the positive side and minimize the impact, you know what happens? It gives you the strength to face whatever hurdles are coming your way today. You are enriching today's life, because sometimes people ask me also when I tell them about whatever I was telling you just now. They say, why even go back into the past? Why relive all that? Why all that? Anyway, I'm busy with my life now. I've got so many things to look into. Why don't I focus on that? Yes, do focus on your current life, but be aware that your current life is being impacted by the negative thoughts that you are carrying forward. And your, you know, activities today, your, what do you say, mental attitude today, the way you struggle, the way you want to achieve, your optimism, everything increases if you decide to pay more and more and more focus on the happy memories that you had. When DCS students join, I give them a questionnaire. And I ask a very wide range of questions in that. And one of the questions that I ask is, can you recall one of the happiest memories of your life? It's very interesting to note that a number of ladies write, when I gave birth to my child, that tops as one of the happiest memories. Now, I take you back to the same thing that I was asking you. Pregnancy, childbirth is a very painful thing. You suffer, most women suffer very badly, right from pregnancy going all the way to the childbirth. So why do they say that this was one of the happiest memories? And that is what I tell you, that there are two sides to the coin. You struggled. You went through pain, you went through suffering. But once the baby was born, all you could think of is, I gave birth to my baby. So you choose, isn't it? A woman can continue to say, My God, 9 months I went through such a horrible time, and this, I had to be on bed, and I was getting morning sickness, and then this happened, and then that happened. It didn't go on, and finally when it came to, you know, the delivery time, it was even worse at that time, and this happened, and that happened, all these things. But remember that it is your choice. The lady chooses to say that this was the happiest occasion in my life. Now, once you start cherishing and putting them up, what I would like you to do is to treat them like a fixed deposit. These are memories which can never be taken away from me. If you are that type of person, write it down and put it up somewhere. Maybe a few selected, you know, happy memories. You can take a printout and put it up on your wall somewhere. So when you come back home tired after a day's work, or you wake up in the morning and you're not feeling up to it, just glance through it. And suddenly you'll see yourself perking up to it. If you can share it with people, even better. Just as a casual sharing, when you meet up with your friend or you're talking to somebody close to you, just say, see, I was recalling what happened so many years back, and this, and that time, you know, this happened, and I was so happy with that. Even sharing with somebody gives you that little boost, gives you that feeling that, yes, I do have these cherished memories safely put in my safe deposit vault. And once you start realizing that I am capable of recalling, cherishing, enjoying my happy memories, please teach others. You know, there is a proverb which says that the best way to learn something is to teach others. I don't know how applicable it is to academic studies, but definitely I can tell you about, you know, learning about life skills. If you can teach others, somebody comes to you and says, I have these horrible memories, I suffered badly because of that, or I'm suffering badly even now, with that. Teach these little tips and techniques that I have been discussing with you. And subsequently, if they agree and they also start doing that, you start celebrating their happy memories. Can you do that? Nothing to do with you. But this friend, this acquaintance, or whatever that person is to you, says that I have this very, very happy memory about this. Try to visualize. Try to put yourself in the shoes of that person and think, if that had happened to me, how would I feel? If I say yes, I would also feel happy. And I'm happy for my friend that he or she went through this. That increases your own happiness. The same way, even today, whatever life may be treating you or whatever you may be going through today, try to create more and more happy memories. We come to a nice serene place like Manthan. It's up to me to recall certain happy memories. And those happy memories can be very, very, very simple. There are these two stray dogs in Manthan. I meet them only occasionally when I come. So I meet them, I pet them, this, that, then I get busy with whatever it is, and then I go off. And in the night, I go to my room and I bolt the door and I go to sleep. It's uncanny. When I wake up and open the door, both of them are sitting there staring at the door and wagging their tail. Who am I to them? I'm not their master. I don't feed them. I don't even pet them on a regular basis. What is this loyalty that these people are giving me? Now, if I can record that memory in my mind, sometimes when I'm expecting somebody to be nice to me and that person is not being nice or not being thankful, even when I've done good to them, I recall this and I say, what good did I do to these two dogs that they have to be, and for how long they've been sitting there, I don't know. This is how we, you know, create situations where even today, if you start looking at it, you start getting this, you know, your bank of happy memories increases. And finally, most important, please remember, many of us, as we grow older, our memories start becoming dim. Sometimes we don't recollect. We say, oh yeah, something had happened, I don't remember very clearly. Oh yeah, who is that person? I'm trying to recollect. When you start going into that sunset years of your life, if you already have this huge, you know, fixed deposit of your cherished memories, just open that and start reading up from there. And let your imagination go wild. Recall as much as you can for each of those and see how your life, even if there are challenges, even if there is a dimming of the memory, even that. So I'm giving you this tip to help you. It does not matter whether you are 20, 40, 60, 80. Age is only a number. But this will take care of a lot of future challenges and future hurdles. If you can keep that in mind and work on it, I'm going to be a very happy person. And this hour of today will become a very, very happy memory for me. So with that, let me stretch out. And Purni is back making a couple of announcements. I'll be back in 1 minute.
So we are receiving a lot of happy hearts. They are popping up like that. And some thumbs ups coming up. So if you want to have happy memories, one place where you will surely be able to get it is Manthan. Alright. So now, if you have a bunch of school kids, or if you have college kids, or if you have a nice big group of, you know, your own family, friends, people, anyone, you can come down, use this place, and maybe our whole team will be happy to conduct a workshop also for you. It can be residential workshop, day-long workshop. We can go ahead and do it. And for this camp, we have our people from our alumni also who have all, you know, come here. So let me just show you a few of them. So I'm going to lift this phone and first show you Sonal. Sonal wants to... So Sonal is our social media in charge. So we are all like technologically challenged and none are novices. So Sonal helps us out. And here is our dear friend Surekha. Surekha.
Hi, hi.
So usually Surekha is the first one to ask questions. And today she will do it directly.
No, she's typed it down.
She's typed it already. Wow, y'all. And next to Surekha is Yashoda.
Hi.
And taking brisk notes is Neeta.
Hi.
So Neeta, when did you do your DCS course here?
2003 and 4.
3 and 4. Surekha, Yashoda?
No, 4 and 5.
See, they're all 3 and 4, 4 and 5. And Sonal is 2008.
7 and 8.
7 and 8. And one of the days she may possibly do is Deepali. Deepali, tell her hi.
Hi.
And there... we have these two young ladies and one handsome man, Girish. So they are all over here. And look at this place. How beautifully green it is. And the weather is so, so cooperative. There is a huge water body there. It's filled up with lot of water. I think that drops the temperature also by a degree or more. So we are all over here. Oh yeah, see if you can see that, there was this campfire. So how the program also pans out is, you have sessions by Ali, then we do a lot of activities, then you have sessions, you have talks, you have introspection, actualization, any word that we can give, but then we go back a little more thoughtful, bringing in a little more meaning to our lives. And then in the evening, we have a campfire. So yesterday we had a campfire. So we had mimicry, we had jokes, we had singing, and we had dance and unchartered talents. Everything got blossomed out in the camp over here. And we have many, many happy ladies because they don't have to plan the menu. They don't have to make chai, nothing. Everything is ready. They just have to come and chill. So that was happened. And what's going to happen is more activities, more sessions. And tonight we are also going to have a karaoke evening. So few of us will croak. Few of us will sing. Few of us will do debut performances. And while I have made you jealous, I want to make you happy thinking of wanting to come back to this place. I'll give it back to Ali for all your questions and a lot of answers. So over to Ali, who will be here in a jiffy.
And see this happy memories being
happy memories.
Created by Dolly. She has climbed right over the table. And go, Dolly. Go. Good girl.
Get down.
Good.
Good girl. Go. Hi. No. Go.
Yes. Yes, Dolly. No, please. Okay? No climbing up. Okay, good girl. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So, Asha Chandraprabha had written right in the beginning.
Right.
Yes, sir, memories do not change, but people take it for granted and look for quick fixes.
Absolutely, Asha. You are very right. When you look for quick fixes, when all you focus on is those, what do you call it, memes and one-minute videos and Instagrams and this and that, you are missing out on the in-depth memories of things which you have really had a good time with.
Yeah, and Surekha has typed down, though she's here. Good memories are the timeless treasures of the heart. They help us in making the shift from a lousy mood to a great one.
So when I'm in a lousy mood, when I'm feeling upset or something, all I need to do is to recall those good memories, which, as Surekha rightly said, they are timeless treasures. If you don't allow them to dim, that's what I was telling you, then they remain with you for life.
Asha also says that, does the question arise for people, what have we done with our lives, and then take cognition and move forward? Or is it life just lock and key?
Not at all, Asha. It is far beyond lock and key. It is not restricted to that. Yes, what have we done with our lives? This helps us to recall what we have done with our lives. As I said, yes, there will be bad memories also. There may be regrets, there may be guilt or whatever it is. Doesn't matter. Only thing is that if you have certain bad memories which are affecting your life today, then, as I said, resolve it, please. Because these are just memories. These are just, emotional impacts. That phase, that era of your life is over. But do not be stuck to that. And that is what, if you achieve, you will find that you can do wonders.
Asha also says, does a person label happy and sad memories just because things do not work for them?
Yes, Asha, that's exactly what I was telling you, no? A person says that, I was bullied by my senior, so it is a bad memory. But when I help that person to go more in depth and think and introspect, and the same person says, there was one boy, who was my senior. I hardly knew him, but he came up to the occasion. He stood by me. Not only that, he came the next day to my house to inquire how are you and to tell that, these fellows are, useless characters. Don't take them seriously. Nothing will happen to you. How much he gave me that support. Now you see how the tables have been turned. Now, it is up to you to identify and acknowledge that it is a happy memory.
Mary says, I will do this. I will start writing this small cute journal for my happy memories.
Absolutely, Mary. I'll be really happy to see your progress and to see how consistent you are in doing it. And like I said, please spread the message. Tell this to others. People get inspired. And you know that what we call as peer pressure? If somebody who is close to them, somebody who is a good friend, if that person says, I am doing this, it has a greater impact than if somebody like me says, because it's always there, yeah, he knows, he tells all these, yeah, what he says is good. But me, I'm not that great, I can't do it. But if I realize, my friend Mary is doing it, she's like me. She's not somebody great or a teacher or a preacher or whatever it is, she's like me. And she's doing it, and she's doing it on a regular basis. Hey Mary, how come you're doing this? How are you keeping it consistent? So she'll tell you things that, no, you know, in the night I used to get tired and I used to skip. So I decided that I will do it in the morning. Or I decided that just after lunch I'll take a few minutes aside and I'll sit and write those journals or this or that. I found that to be a better method. So you can, you know, motivate each other through this whole process.
Okay, Asha has one more question. Does everything works according to the timetable of the universe?
Absolutely not, because the universe does not have a timetable. That's the beauty of it. Who made timetables? We, the modern man. Universe did not make any timetable. Animals, birds, insects, flora and fauna, plants, nobody has a timetable. It is only we human beings who made it. Take a simple thing like, you know, when people say, oh, it's 1 o'clock, it's my lunchtime, I'm hungry. You're programming yourself into belief. If your clock had stopped at 12:30 and if you had glanced at it and seen that it is 12:30, you would have said, I'm not hungry. We've got half an hour more. Let me finish some other work. That's how your mind works. You have that control over your mind. Remember that and use it to your advantage.
Surekha says, sometimes you don't know the value of a moment until it becomes a memory.
Correct. You have to convert it into a memory. It may or may not become a memory, remember that. It may just pass off and you may neglect and you may even forget it. But that's what I was saying. One is to identify, list out and cherish the memories of the past. The other is start making the memories of today. You saw how that Dolly was so enthusiastic. She literally climbed over the table and came and she showed her face to all of you. What is it? What is that love that a stray dog like that has? What does she understand? Who am I? What is she doing? But she also teaches me a lot along with other human beings.
Asha says, as my journey of pregnancy was an ordeal, thank God it's over. So what next was or is my question throughout?
Yes. Tell yourself, okay, you went through a bad time. It's like somebody saying, I wanted to go to my best friend's birthday party where all my very close friends are there and we are going to have a wonderful time. But I got stuck in a traffic jam. I got onto a bus which failed. I was told that there is a road which has been blocked over here and you have to take a detour. I suffered so much. But when you finally reach your destination, what is it that you finally recall and cherish? It is that party, it is that friend, it is that occasion. And it is up to you. There are people who will complain. They'll go to that party and spend half an hour telling them what a bad time they had in the journey. It's over, no? Yes, tell people that, you know, next time I should do something about it because this road seems to be pretty bad and we get stuck in this traffic, so I'll look at it. That's it. You don't have to give a minute-by-minute, recall of everything that happened to you in that journey. And that depends on your attitude.
Surekha says, when bad memories harass me, I say to myself, in order for this incident to happen, there should be someone who does the wrong and someone who suffers the wrong. Yeah. I'm grateful that I suffered the wrong and not commit the wrong.
Yeah.
And the pain significantly reduces.
Reduces. Absolutely. Absolutely. I 100% agree with that. And that, again, I repeat, is only a question of attitude.
Yeah, and she even says, today looking back on the tears makes me laugh, but I also realize that looking back on the laughs brings me tears.
Yes. Tears are a part of life. Happiness and sadness are complementary to each other. Smiles and tears go hand in hand. Accept them both.
Navina says, I think when we focus on good memories, one more good thing happens. That is, we attract more and more of such moments, which further create happy memories as energy flows where thoughts goes.
Very true. Very true. Absolutely agree with that.
Meena says, bad or sad memories become painless only when we are healed from that memories.
Yeah, but I would not go to the extent of saying only when you are healed. When you start the process of healing, that's enough. If you are healed 20%, recall any physical injury that you had. It was very painful. But if you did something by which the pain reduced 20%, didn't you celebrate? Didn't you say, yeah, yesterday I was in so much pain. Today I am significantly better. I think I am on the way to healing. Same thing happens with the mental state.
Ashwini says, I was teased, bullied by my friend for no reason. She just wanted to hurt me, and that is a very bad memory to me.
Absolutely.
How do I resolve it?
Absolutely, Ashwini. Again, this thing of empathy comes in. Can you just detach yourself that you are the victim and think from that individual's point of view? What made that person want to actively and purposely hurt somebody who's supposed to be a friend, that too, not somebody who's an enemy or somebody who's in conflict with? That means that person is in a miserable state of mind. The person is suffering. The person is guilty. The person is ashamed. The person is feeling that I have not been able to achieve anything great. And that is what they take out by bullying somebody else who is a soft target. And your getting bullied allowed her to vent out whatever negativity she had. And now you know that she is this type of person. You keep your distance, physically if possible, otherwise emotionally. You learned a lesson that, see, this is how people behave. I have to be careful about it and move on with life.
Navina says, the more we master the skill of looking into positive of a not so good event overall, the more we shift our life towards more positivity.
Very true. It's a continuous process. Slow and steady, but it happens on a continuous basis. Don't expect miracles. Don't expect results in one day, one week, one month also. But I, with years and decades of experience, I can tell you, eventually, it does bring about that change, and that change becomes a transformation. It is permanent.
Tamanna says, I am sad that I couldn't be at Manthan today. But on the other hand, still making happy memories, listening to Ali about happy memories.
Fantastic, Tamanna. And Tamanna gave us such wonderful memories of our visit to Chintamani where she stays. And I want to also remind Tamanna that she had said that she will get her gang of friends and neighbors and all that and bring them all over here for a Manthan camp. I will be looking forward to do it. And Tamanna is such a good organizer. I'm sure she will do it. She has created such wonderful memories for everybody.
Rita says, bad memories last forever, not good memories.
No, they don't. Allow me to differ here a little bit, Rita, that they last forever because we dwell on them. We nurture them. We go on brooding with them. And that's why they become permanent. But if you tell yourself that, no, I will not allow these bad memories to control me. I will not allow them to take possession of me. Whatever has happened has happened. And like I said, I will resolve them at an emotional level. You see how they slowly start fading away.
Surekha says, good memories are precious snapshots of time. They feed the feel-good champions like serotonin and dopamine and contribute to our mental health.
Absolutely, no doubt about it. But you don't even need to know the technicalities or the medical things. It is a fact that it helps. Don't worry how it does, but I can assure you, and I'm sure there are many, many people like me who have experienced, who have seen people, who have understood you know, all various aspects of life, they will confirm to you that it is a fact.
And the last one, Navina says, I think what we say bad memory stays longer. It's because we have energized it more by thinking about it time and again. Again, it is our choice.
Absolutely. This is what memory. I am very, very particular about. Please make a strong note of this. It is a choice. So many people somehow tend to give up by saying, I am fated to be, you know, in pain or to suffer. I think this is my karma. I don't think life will improve. I think I will continue to suffer like this. In fact, I would even like to tell you very, very confidently, pain is inevitable. Suffering is optional. Yes, Tamanna says very soon. So that's a good positive thing. And I will, you know, look forward to it as we always look forward to Mantanna camps, even to the others, even people who are part of this FB Live program on Saturdays and all that. Why don't we have something on a weekend, on a Saturday, where instead of you, you know, sticking to the 6 inches of your mobile screen, expand to 6 acres of nature and beauty and come and join us. We will organize something where we will all get together and take up these type of topics and discuss things.
Surekha says, the interesting thing is that we can create happy memories for others. This area is within our control.
Yes, we can create happy memories for others. We can also highlight the happy memories for others. Like I told you that case where I helped the person to understand that there was this one person who stood by him, and that is a happy memory in the sad memory of being bullied.
And Navina says, actually, we are makers of our destiny by the choices we make.
That's it. Please underline the word choice. We choose. 90% of what we experience is our choice. Because the way we choose what to do. But we at times surrender ourselves by saying, no, I can't do this. This is not possible. It is very difficult. I don't think I will succeed. The only people who do not succeed are the people who do not try. So if you make up your mind that the worst that will happen is that I will succeed or I will partially fail. But the worst that will happen if I don't try is that I will definitely fail. So which is the better of the choices?
That answers Asha's next question. Are we really maker of our destiny?
Yes, yes. I am a strong believer that you can create your destiny. Maybe not in material terms. You can't create a destiny of getting a job or building a big house or whatever else you call as destiny. But within yourself, within your mind, you are definitely the creator of your destiny.
Navina says, Ali, I love the benefit you said that journaling helps in sunset years.
All of you, please keep that in mind. Sometimes we think, oh, that sunset years, when is this going to happen? When I tell youngsters, you know, when I'm doing this aptitude testing or career guidance, I tell them, select a career which you will be happy doing even when you're 70, 80 years old. Oh, who wants to live that long? I tell them, okay, you want to commit suicide? It's fine, I'll help you with that. But short of that, let me tell you that longevity and healthcare is improving. You can be, if you choose to be a productive member of society, even in your 70s and 80s, maybe even 90s. I don't know. I cannot predict the future.
Surekha says, the main thing is to keep the main thing. The main thing.
Absolutely.
And good memories are the main thing for sure. Yeah.
And the flip side of it, you have heard this quote that, you know, don't sweat the small stuff. And everything is small stuff. Don't sweat meaning don't worry yourself and don't get caught with what the author defines as, you know, small stuff. Everything negative is small stuff. Everything positive is big stuff. Mm-hmm. And with those thoughts, I want to leave you and enjoy the rest of my stay here in Manthan, inviting you, welcoming you anytime, even if you want to have your own camps over here with your family or friends or relatives. The place is available to you. It's a non-commercial thing. We don't rent it out to big people and this and that, but we definitely keep it open for our friends and, you know, other people who would like to come and get away from the concrete jungle and spend some quality time over here.
Shirin's.
Yes, Shirin has added that old photographs also bring back happy memories. Yes. And those old photographs which used to be taken by a camera and then the reel used to be completed, you had to wait till 36 photos are over, then take it to very carefully to that studio. And they would ask you to come back after 3 days. And then you would take those printouts. And then you would ask for some enlargements of a few. And then you would say, oh, it's so expensive to have photos. There was a little pleasure and joy in all those things, isn't it? Delayed gratification, waiting for something, instead of immediately taking a selfie and sending it off. People have even stopped enjoying the moment because they are more particular about taking selfies and sharing it with them.
And then... Yeah, it's deleted from the gallery when it is downloaded.
Yes, and then it gets deleted and you don't know. Anyway, so much so for everybody. Let me also thank you all for having been here. Surekha is also adding the last point, that is, educating the heart is as important as educating the mind. And the way to do that is by nurturing good memories. I think that's a wonderful closing statement. So with that, I leave you to have a nice weekend. Enjoy yourself. Bye-bye.